uncompromising unit.
That says it all.
It certainly does. 1 point in the scheme of things, and Brisbane had their chances. Alistair Lynch didn't kick well for goal. The Craig McRae kick. There were some tired Brisbane players in that last quarter. Some missed opportunities. But they were gallant, the champions, Brisbane. They were fantastic. But you cannot underestimate this team. They are the real deal. And I think whoever beats them is going to win it.
Couple of weeks, had a couple of down weeks against the Geelong and the Western Bulldogs, but they've really got it together over the last couple of weeks. They knew they were coming up against the challengers and the champions in 2 weeks in a row. One they smashed, the other they've come away.
20-74 to 5-9-39.
Okay, 19-28.
Collingwood defeated.
19-36.
Collingwood defeated South Melbourne.
77 replay.
19-44. Got it here in the book, 1944.
Fitzroy defeated Richmond, 9-12-66 to 7-9-51.
That is unbelievable.
Absolutely. Here's one for you. Port Adelaide, last year, round 16. Who'd they play? Got any idea? You can say anything because I don't know either. But, you know the halftime scores. Your dad's next door. Dad, what's some of the other fantastic stats?
I know they played against Kangaroos and they lost.
Yeah, well.
14-15-99 to 10-10-70.
Yep. That's right.
That's right. He's got it.
Hey, Tim, can I just ask a question, Tim? You couldn't do my tax for me, could you, mate?
Anyhow, Tim.
You could.
That is fantastic. We've asked him questions out the back. He has not missed one of them since the game started. That is amazing.
Actually,
congratulations.
And David's his dad there, David.
There's one that Timmy wanted to say. Timmy, tell us Sam's stats.
His name is John Newman. He was born 22nd of December 1945. He played for Geelong from 1964 to 1980. Kicked. Played 300 games, kicked 110 goals, has been married 3 times, has had 24 girlfriends and 3 kids that we know of.
Little smart ass.
Good on you, Tim.
That is fantastic.
Well done. Every one of those was correct. The only one we could really pick up on was 122, 127, Doug Wade, but everything else was fantastic. So well done, Tim. Sorry, David.
Yeah, I was just going to say the other thing, because he's read so many combinations of goals from behind, you can just spit any score at him. And he's actually got like a photographic memory and he sees the answer. He just reckons he guesses, but he actually sees it. He doesn't work it out. That's the way his mind works.
Good on you, Tim. You haven't got Tats Lotto numbers for Saturday night.
What, so if we said 29-15, you'd know what that is, would you?
Yes.
29-15. 189. We've no idea. We're just going to write that down.
We'll come back after the... Not this break, the break after. We'll come back. 29?
6 nines are 54, carry 5. 6 and 4, 17, carry 5. What did you say? What did you say it was?
189.
That is correct.
Good on you, Tim.
Last week on the House of Bulger.
But if that's not mine, I'm not the one having a baby.
And I'm pregnant.
Hank, look at this.
I see the art lessons haven't paid off.
No, Mum's pregnant.
Are you sure we do this every night, Chelsea?
Every night. You take me, and we make mad, passionate love.
And every night, you get me to take the pictures.
I don't think so, Joffa.
Struth, even with amnesia, you're no fun.
Oh, wow. Oh, my God, Hank, I've been waiting for so long for this.
Well, as you know, my beautiful and faithful wife, Joybell, is expecting a bundle of joy.
An absolute miracle, more like it.
Well, now, no one was more surprised than me. Just shows you my boys still must be able to swim.
But, Dad, didn't you have a vasectomy?
You're right, my little poppet. They must be good climbers as well as swimmers.
Anyway, your father and I would like to have a little talk about your inheritance.
You see, with a third child on the way, the Bulger family fortune will now be divided three ways instead of the two.
Cursed. I mean, of course, of course.
And also, according to the Bulger family charter, the offspring of the eldest child also gets an equal share.
As if Hank the little dweeb could father a child. By the way, where is Hank?
Hank's with Chelsea in his room, giving her a bit of a workout.
If you know what I mean.
Shouldn't we be saving ourselves for our wedding night?
Hank Bulger, this time you've gone too far.
Houston Crab, my arch enemy.
Oh, no. Bumped your head and brought your memory back.
Who are you?
Houston Crab, my arch...
Who am I?
Houston Crab, my arch.
Has this happened before?
No one touches Hank Bulger.
Hank, you're back. You remember?
The Bulger is back. Put some clothes on, Chelsea. You look ridiculous.
Brody Holland? I've never seen such horrific facial injuries. Why, you're a mangled wreck. Sorry, Mick, my mistake.
David Parkins said that Carlton would be cutting off their noses to spite their faces if they won their remaining games. If their potential use of scissors resembles anything to do with their ball handling skills, they'd be hard pressed to cut anything off. I wonder what the folk at Broadmeadows think. What do you think about Carlton losing all their games for the rest of the year so they
all,
can get...
All crook business, all skeleton. Collingwood came in the cup this year. Every 90, 13 years ago, Collingwood is the cup. You bet anything. I see my dream. I don't know, give it the telephone.
You're either speaking very bad English or very good Greek, sir. We are asking people, should Carlton lose all their games so they get draft picks, or should they try and win the rest of their games?
I'm a Carlton supporter.
Well, what do you think? Well, you're the perfect person to ask, madam. What do you think? Would you rather them win the rest of their games or lose them so they can get picks at the end
well,
of the year?
They're doing a pretty good job at losing, aren't they?
It's dead people. I mean, having father, five kids, four boys, one girl. Having family. What do you do here after 20 years? The animals, you see the animals, the kangaroos come here, I eat it. Because now people, the government father, not heavy father, man. Any family, no father. The government father.
Anyhow,
because he pie. He give pie. Sometimes no working, sometimes cigarette, marijuana. I always go to the unemployment and give money now, what am I?
Anyhow.
Maybe father die, mother go to queue.
How are you?
How you say? 50-50.
Do you think try and lose the game so they can get picks?
On a more serious note, don't worry about Carlton. The Norwich rising star was who? Cole from Collingwood. Is that an absolute disgrace or what? You got Marty McGrath, kicked 5 goals, and Eddie being Eddie, Mr. Collingwood. Cole, Richard Cole, that's...
bullshit and embarrassing, Sammy.
Now, sir, just a little bit of...
Job?
Yeah, what, just tied you over till the end of the week?
Oh, no, that's just for today. That's just for me to eat now. Yeah. And then come back here later before it closes and fill up another trolley. No, it's just for the week.
For the week, yeah. What, you got a big family?
Two... partner, two kids, plus two extras in a previous relationship from her.
You got one?
I don't know. Yeah.
The Norwich Rising Star nominee was Richard Colton. It should be Martin McGrath
and from
Richmond.
And you reckon...
Five goals... Oh, look at this. You stole the thunder. Look.
And you reckon... That was Roy Rogers.
Roy Rogers or Roy Wright?
He'd get a game for
Colton. How are you, sir?
Good.
What are you doing?
Oh, shopping.
You shoplifting? You're an electrician, are you?
Yeah.
Now, go on, this
is... Carlton song.
Yeah. Dennis Pagan, he's having trouble with the blues at the minute.
Oh, okay, the blues.
Yeah, the blues.
Since my baby left me, I've got a new place to dwell. Down behind the back pocket in the Carlton Hotel. Well, I'm struggling here, Sam. Would you like to help me out on a few words?
You got a new photo phone, have you?
No, I haven't. No, I wish I did.
Yeah, I guess so.
The ordinary phone. The old one, very old.
I built my house with bricks like that, sir. What is that? Righto, well, what about this one, blue suede shoes? Righto, here we go.
Right.
One for the money, two for the show, three to get ready now, go, go, step on my blue suede shoes.
They're going, look at that.
You can do anything, belong all for my blue suede.
Yes, indeed. It's time now for Mastermind as we get through to the semi-finals. Now, there you go, mate. In the front row, have the Mars bar over there. And our contestant tonight is a Collingwood fan. It's Ian Westman. We might remember when Ian was on the show where he told us that his grandfather, Bill Moody, a former vice president of Collingwood. And Ian, though, is the business development manager for...
HSBC.
The bank. Good on you, mate. Another banker in action. Now, you finished seventh on the home and away series with $1,400. You know the routine here, don't you?
Yep.
You saw last week, we've got a little change when we get to the photos. We're going to show you some photos that you have to wait till the end and then tell us who they all are. You know the routine, though? Each question's worth $50 and away you go. And when we get to the end, you can bet it all up and see if you can get it through to play for $20,000 thanks to Mars. You ready, Ian?
Yep.
3 minutes and your time starts now. What colour flags were used to signal the 9-point goal in this year's Wizard Home Loans Cup?
Pass.
True or false? There has never been a crowd of more than 100,000 at a home and away game of league football.
True
is right. 99,000, Collingwood, Melbourne at 58. Which Geelong player recently announced his retirement after a career dogged by two knee reconstructions?
Warnow
is correct. Name the high-priced recruit who joined Melbourne from Sturt in 1971.
Tilbrook.
John Tilbrook, Diamond Jim. True or false? Throughout his career, Melbourne champion Robert Flower played in one finals game.
True.
False, he played three, all in his last year. Who has been West Coast's only winner of the Coleman Medal?
Pass.
Come back to it. Question 7. Which current cat was Hawthorne's leading goal kicker in 1999?
Lord.
Lord's correct, with 42. Which St Kilda player of the 1980s was known as Joppa?
Cunningham.
Jeff Cunningham. Who was named as captain of Fitzroy's team of the century?
I saw this on the wall the other day. Kevin Murray?
Kevin Murray's correct. True or false, Ben Graham's grandfather played over 200 games for South Melbourne?
True.
Jack Graham played 227 for the Swans in the 30s and the 40s. To the photos. Five photos, who are they?
Davis, Wells, Kingsley, Farmer.
Wrong. Kickett and Robert Klomp with the other ones. Barry Davis, Kickett, Klomp, Kingsley, Wells. Question 16. Jason and Mark Johnson both played with which TAC Cup side?
Pass.
Come back to it. Who holds the club record of 14 goals in a game for the Kangaroos?
Longmire
in 1990 against Melbourne. Name the three league clubs Adam Huskus played with.
Port Adelaide, Swans, Brisbane.
Correct. Question 19. Laurie Bellotti played 24 games of league football for which club?
Carlton.
West Coast Eagles. How many footballers have kicked over 1,000 league goals?
Five.
Five is correct. We'll come back to them. Jason and Mark Johnson played TAC Cup for who? Have a guess. 20 seconds.
Rangers.
Wrong. Quarter Cannons. Who has been West Coast's only winner of the Coleman Medal? 10 seconds.
Modra.
Scott Cummings. No. What colour flags were used to signal 9-point goal in the Wizard Cup homes?
Orange.
Orange is correct with 1 second to go. Well done. Good job, Ian. Good effort. And the question's getting tougher as we get into the final stakes here. You said how many footballers have kicked... I asked you how many kicked 1,000 goals. You said five, and that's right. Lockett, Coventry, Dunstall, Wade and Ablett. All right, you've got $700. How much are you going to risk? Ironically, lot. You got $1,400 last time, so what are you going to do, the lot?
Go again.
We're going to go the lot. Okay.
Come on now.
Now, watch the video, because this time the question is pertaining to what you're going to see on the screen. Go.
He's on a lead. Get the runner out there and pick up the pig. Enough said.
Oh,
fine tackle. What a magnificent tackle.
Incredible scenes as a pig ran on to the SCG. Now, here's the question. Can you name the Swans footballer who finally stopped Little Plugger with that diving tackle?
Jeez, I've got no idea there.
This is for the a lot.
Bolton?
Bolton is incorrect, Ian. Have we got any takers from anyone?
Ask Tim.
Ask who?
Tim.
Tim, do you know? No, it wasn't Dunkley. No, Tim, you got that one wrong. Anybody know in the audience tonight? Bloke up there, their hand up. Who? No, it was Darren Holmes. Darren Holmes was the man.
Well known.
So bad luck, mate. You've ended up with the big zero. Yep. So there you go. Bad luck, Ian. That's enough audience. We'll just get to the break. You can have a bit of a chat in a moment, mumbling over there. But, mate, as we said, the question's always going to get a bit tougher on the run home there. But bad luck. Congratulations. You did very well to get the $700. But what we will give you is, how many Mars bars can we give? Somebody upstairs, tell me. We give you a year's supply of Mars bars. How about that?
That's great. I'm a diabetic.
You're a diabetic. Oh, well... If going to zero is not going to kill you, the prize will.
But, certainly, that will.
Mate, you give them to the local kiddies or something like that.
I'll give them somehow.
Bad luck, pal. It looks like you're out of it, Ian. But thanks very much for playing Mastermind. That's the way the cookie crumbles. And as you can see, you couldn't rig it just because you're a Collingwood man either, mate.
Nah, bad luck, Sam.
Just shows you. We'll take a break. When we come back, we've got plenty more to go on the footy show. By the way, almost footy legends. We'll drop it this week because we're running out of time. But if you've got some footy legends to win the match. Just in case you reckon two is a fluke, three out of three ain't bad. Have a look at this. Fantastic grab there by young Marty McGrath. And they'll be hoping he can do that and kick another five.
I met a girl last Saturday night. Yeah. Had a dress so tight. You turn me on, she said.
You're coming on strong.
And my man is standing right behind you.
Oh. Now everybody wants a thing, God.
Yeah.
It don't matter if you need it or not.
And I need you more, the more you push me away.
Oh, yeah. You want me to look, but you don't want me to touch. Now I never needed you so much.
You better listen up, girl.
I'm only gonna give it up.
That's right.
To only one man.
Only one man.
And I don't love you. No. I said, don't worry about a thing. Cause for what I got planned, babe, you don't need to know.
Now everybody wants a thing.
And
it don't matter if you need it or not.
And I need you more. The more you push me away.
Yeah.
Said I know you're busting the kids. Come on.
I wanna get me some of that.